गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज राजेश जाधव, योर इंग्लिश मास्टर टीचर। इन टुडेस सेशंस वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ वेरी पॉपुलर पोएम रिटन बाय रॉबर्ट फॉक्स एंड द नेम ऑफ दैट पोएम इज फायर एंड आइस। फ्रेंड्स, फायर एंड आइस इज द मोस्ट पॉपुलर पोएम ऑफ रॉबर्ट फॉक्स। बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट दिस पोएम, आई वुड लाइक टू डिस्कस दिस पोएम। I would like to start this poem with a quotation. See friends, do not allow the negative feelings and emotions to control your mind. Do not allow negative feelings to control negative feelings and emotions to control your mind. See, here in this quote, the writer want to tell us that we have to control our negative feelings, because if these negative feelings control your mind, then definitely it is a cause of distractions. Okay? And so, emotional harm does not come from others. It means what? Your emotional harms. For example, the feeling of greed, feeling of jealousy, it does not come from others. It is a conceit and developed within ourselves. These feelings, these negative feelings are not coming from others. These conceive or develop in our self. See, I have started this poem with this quote because basically the theme of this poem is also relevant with this quote. So, this quote tells us we have to control our negative feelings. If we may not control that negative feelings start to control our mind, and definitely it is a cause of destruction. That is also the theme of this poem. That is also the message that poet want to convey throughout this poem. And so I have started this poem with this quotation. Friends, after discussing the quotation, I will turn towards the poet Robert Frost. Who is he? Already in our previous lecture, I have discussed with you about Robert Frost. I told you he was a modern American poet. He was a 20th century most popular poet. He was born on 1874 and died on 1963. Friends, Robert Frost is known for his realistic depictions of rural life and his command of American colloquial speech. In our previous video also, we have discussed this point. I told you, if you examine the poems of Robert Frost, then you will understand these poems are based on the rural life setting. And by using this setting, the poet depicts the picture of rural life. Okay? And through this, it presenting the philosophy of life. And same thing is here. In today's sessions, whatever we are discussing, that we have to apply in our daily life. Okay? This poem presenting the philosophy of life. And friends, the Robert Frost is the only American poet who received the four Pulitzer Prizes for poetry in his life. He was the only one poet in America who got this award for poetry section. Friends, till this point you understood very well. Now, we will turn towards the fire and ice. After discussing about the poem, we will turn towards the poem. Okay? The poet has taken an inspiration from Dante's Inferno, canto number 3. Dante's Inferno is also indicating the same philosophy, same thoughts. Okay, and he has taken the inspiration from that, and he has written this poem, Fire and Ice. Friends, Fire and Ice was published in 1920s December. The first time it was published in Harper's Magazine. See, the first time it was published in Harper's Magazine, and then after in 1923. His Pulitzer Prize winning book, New Hampshire. Second time it was published in 1923, it was published in New Hampshire. And already I told you, the New Hampshire is the most popular collection of poems, and this collection has also awarded, also received Pulitzer Prize Award. Okay. And the profound idea of the poem is that the world would end either by fire and ice. These two components are there that are responsible for the destruction of the world. That is the profound thought. That is the main idea. That is the core idea of this poem. Okay? And both components compared with the self-destructing human emotions, hatred and desires. See, the fire and ice is a symbolic poem. Okay? These both components stand for human emotions. Okay? Hatred and desire. The word desire stands for your greed, lust, avarice. Okay? Cruelty, that indicating by the word desire, and ice stand for hatred. Hatred means here jealousy, insensitivity. Okay? That thought, that profound idea has been presented by the poet from this poem. So, what does the poet say? We will discuss line by line meaning of this poem, and by discussing of this meaning, we will gain how this profound thought has presented throughout this poem, how he has presented the philosophy of life throughout this lesson, throughout this poem. Why does the poet say that we have to control our negative feelings? Otherwise, the negative feelings can control your mind, and if they started to control our mind, then it may be the cause of our destruction. That is the profound thought, that is the profound idea, that is the main thought of this poem. How does the poet has presented this thought throughout this poem, that we will discuss. Now, for this discussion, I will read the poem. So, open your book and we will start this poem. So friends, let's read the poem, Fire and Ice. Some say the world will end in fire, some say in ice. From what I have tasted of desire, I hold those who favor fire. But if it had perished twice, I think I know enough of hate to say that for destruction ice is also great and will suffice. So friends, first of all we discuss the meanings of the words. The first word is here, desire. Desire means here, wish. Okay? Second word, that is hold. Hold means here to take sign or to take sign or favor. And the favor here, inclined towards the king. Okay? In the second sandha, the words are here, perish. Perish means here, die. And another word is here, suffice means here, be sufficient. Be sufficient. And the destruction is here, wiping out. Okay, let's start actually meaning of this point. Some say the world will end in fire, some say in ice. Okay, there are two groups. First of all, we'll discuss the scientific reason of the destruction of the world. This poem we have to present in two angles. First of all, first angle is here, scientific view of the destruction, and the second thought, that is the philosophy, that also. Business. It means surface meaning and the hidden meaning of this poem, both meanings will be discussed now. Some say the world will end fire. Who are these some? There is one group of people who believe that one day the earth will be heated so much, the core of the earth will be heated so much, and that is the reason of the destruction of this earth. Okay? And due to that fire, the world will be destruct or destroy. Okay? That is the main reason. It is one group of people. The one group of people is saying that the earth core will be heated so much one day. And due to this fire, it is impossible to live on the earth, and the earth will be destroyed due to this fire. That is the opinion of first group.
some say in eyes. But on the other hand, there is another group of people who believe that one day the earth temperature should go down. Earth temperature should go down and it will become frozen. Okay? And due to this ice, it is impossible to live on the earth and the earth may be perish. The earth may destroy. Okay? It means here the poet present two thoughts. Fire and ice representing two thoughts. One is that desire and another one is ice. Ice represent for hatred feelings. I told you. I discussed with you the meaning of scientific view of destruction. Okay. What philosophy he has presented, that also I will discuss with you. I will discuss with you. See, fire. First of all, we discuss the first group of people that is that believe that due to the fire, the world will be discussed. So, for Greeks, the fire stands for the desire, fiery desire. Okay, I have started this poem with the quotation that try to control your negative feelings, otherwise, the negative feelings may control yourself. Here, fire representing such a negative feelings. And that negative feeling is that, what is that negative feeling? That negative feeling is here, the fire stand for greed. The fire stand for aversion. The fire stand for lust. Okay? And here, the poet says that, I have tasted of desire and over those who favor fire. And the poet is also agree with these people. He said that he is in favor of that people. Whatever they are telling, he agreed with it because the poet has taken such an experience. Okay? And here, so the poet tells us that from what I have tested of desire, means he has taken that experience. Okay? I hold with those who favor fire. Means he also agreed. Okay? Paul is here, he also takes side of that people who believe that the world will be destroyed. World will be destroyed due to the fire. Clear? See, I will give you certain example that you will get a clear idea about it. I told you the scientific view of this destruction, that due to the fire, how the world will be destroyed due to the fire and how the world will be destroyed due to the ice. That scientific point of view I have discussed with you. In your exam, definitely they have a question. Explain the scientific point of view as well as the philosophical thoughts presented by the poet. So, these philosophical as well as scientific thoughts I have discussed with you. Now, I am giving certain examples, then you will get a clear idea. This idea may be clear. Okay? See, your today's condition. What is the today's condition? Today, due to the greed of people, we are cutting forest. And due to the deforestation, due to the cutting of that forest, we are facing numerous problems, number of problems we are facing in our life. For example, the global warming, okay? Then after increase of temperature, then after we decide that the increasing layers of ozones, it's impacting our greed. Due to that greed, we are facing certain problems like a tsunami. Okay, this is the result of our greed. Okay, understood this point? Okay, now in the next stanza of this poem, what does the poet say to us? That we will discuss. But if it had to perish choice, here the poet says that if it had perished, if the world has to destroy again, I think I know enough of it. The first thing he has presented here, in the first stanza he has presented the scientific view, and in the second stanza, okay, he is presenting the philosophy of life. Suppose the world has to destroy toys, then it may perish, it may destroy. I think I know enough of it to save for destruction. Already I told you, ice represented here hate. Hatred feelings, that is our jealousy. That is our insufficiency. That is, and due to that jealousy, okay, the world will be destroyed. I told you that these feelings are never coming from other side. It may develop inside ourselves. I have told you. That's why I was started this morning with a beautiful quotation. To see for the that destruction is also great and would suffice. Suffice means here, that is the sufficient reason for the destruction of this. Friends, till this point you have understood this. See, the fire and ice both are presenting the same issue. Take into consideration, listen carefully. This point is very, very important from the exact point of view. The fire and ice stand for different symbols. Symbol of desire, symbol of the lust, greed, okay? Fire stand for desire, desire representing here, lust, greed, okay? And the ice stand for jealousy, insufficient feeling. But friends, both are presenting the same thought. And that is the thought of destruction, that is the thought of destruction, that's how the world will be perished. That thought has been presented by this poet throughout this. And giving one example, have you read Macbeth? Okay, if you have not, then I am telling you how the greed destroyed, how the jealousy destroyed the people. That is a super example of that jealousy. That is a Macbeth. Macbeth is a very well-known play written by William Shakespeare. And in that play, Macbeth, who is a general, okay, of that kingdom, and his ambition was to become a king. But actually, the king was the King Duncan. Macbeth's ambition was to become a king. He would become a king by winning the love of people, okay? By taking efforts, by winning the love of that king, Duncan. But here, Macbeth had done oppositely. He tried to apply shortcut to gain victory in his life. Okay, it means his ambitions, he became over ambitious and he applied shortcuts. No, I don't have that much time. I want that name and fame immediately now. And that ambitions, okay, took place in his mind and he became over ambitious. And due to that, he decided to kill Duncan. Duncan is the king of that kingdom. And he decided to kill the Duncan, and he had planned very well, and finally he had killed Duncan. See, the beautiful example of jealous feeling, beautiful example of lust. We want more and more. Okay? His ambition was very good. He wanted to become a king. And this philosophy we have to apply in our life. Okay? We may not give chance to negative feelings to control our mind. Here what happened? The Macbeth's mind was controlled by the negative feelings, negative ambitions. He became over ambitious, and due to that, he tried to apply the shortcuts, and in that he came to King Duncan. And finally, when the play came at that time, it's a tragic play, it's a tragedy, and here he also responsible for his own destruction. If you read the Nelson Mandela's lesson, then you will get idea about it. Okay, a long walk to freedom. That in that also Nelson Mandela is telling us that none is responsible for our destructions. We ourselves are responsible for our own destruction. He said that those who are oppressing others, they are not free from it, they also bound in it. See, again listen, those who are oppressing others. That thought as presented by Nelson Mandela in his long, in his autobiography, A Long Walk to Freedom. Those who are oppressing others, those the persons who are feeling jealous of others, okay, that persons may not free from it. They are bound in it, and due to this jealousy, due to that greed, due to that lust, they are destroying ourselves. Friends, this is the meaning of this poem, and here we have completed the stanza-wise explanation of the poem. Now we will discuss poetic device, and then after some important points, some important questions. Okay, you understood? This is the message of the poem. You himself is responsible for our, for your own destructions. None are destroying you. Your negative feelings are reason of your destruction. So finally, the poet gives us message that never give a chance to your negative feelings to control your mind. If you fail to control your negative feelings, the negative feelings may control yourself, and that is the reason of your destruction. Keep in mind, this philosophy has presented by the poet throughout this poem. Okay? So let's start the poetic devices from this point. The first poetic device, that is an alliteration. Alliteration means repetition of consonant sound. Here, the example of alliteration is, some say the world will end in fire, some say in ice. Friends, here the consonant sound S is repeated, as well as the consonant sound W also repeated, and so the figure of speech is here alliteration. Another example of alliteration, I hold with those who favor fire. F is repeated, W is also repeated. Repetition of consonant sound, that is the example of alliteration. So the first figure of speech is here alliteration. Second figure of speech, that is a paradox. Paradox is presented here. Paradox means a true statement but which seems untrue. Example of the paradox, I forgot to write here example. So now the example of paradox is, but if it had to perish twice, see, it seems true, but actually it is untrue. How can one destroy twice? That is a question. So example is here, but if it had to perish twice, that is the example of paradox. Another figure of speech is here, that is a symbolism. I told you this is a very symbolic poem, and the poet has presented symbols of fire, and the fire stands for desire, fiery desire. Okay? And the ice is another symbol. Ice stands for hatred feelings. See, till this point you are clear. Now the rhyming scheme. The rhyming scheme is here A B A A B C B C B. Again, listen. The rhyming scheme of this poem is A B A A B C B C B. Okay? Okay, friends. I hope you understood this poem very well. In our next session, we will discuss the question answer of this poem as far as the board point of view. Friends, basically they are giving a question on the philosophy or the core thought or the theme of this poem. Here, on the fire and hail, definitely have questions. Okay, so be prepared for that. In our next session, we will discuss question answer based on that poetry. Till, thank you very much. We have completed this poem here very well. Okay, thank you.